Project Netherquarium is a series where I try to build an aquarium in the Nether, a dimension where water isn't supposed to be allowed to exist. However, in the previous episode, I was able to exploit a bug involving glow lichen in snapshot 21W03A to place water at the top of the Nether, which I will use as the source for flooding the entire dimension. Good day to you everyone, my name is Whistler, and welcome to episode 2 of Project Netherquarium, the series where I build an aquarium in the most impossible of places, the Nether. I hope you're all having a wonderful day today. So, I have since updated to 1.17, and I've even managed to download a preview for Octafine as well, so that's pretty fun. That said, the plan for today's episode is I need a turtle helmet, so we're going to be hunting down some turtles, and I would also quite like to get myself an axolotl or two. I think they would be an excellent pet to have in this place. I might even make axolotls the first exhibit for the aquarium as well, so that could be fun. At the moment though, I've got the mother source of water above me there at the top of the Nether ceiling, and I was able to create that water source using a bug in snapshot 21W03A where you can place glow lichen inside of a lava source and it actually turns it into water, even in the Nether. So, I've completely broken the game by doing this. It has since been patched though, so don't expect to be able to do that in the official 1.17 release. That's why I started this world in snapshot 21W03A and updated, so that I could begin with water in the Nether. Speaking of water in the Nether though, I also hope to try and add some more water sources to this place. We need to get started on the flooding. Now I'm curious, now that I have Optifine, I don't have the Nether Fox, so is there a Nether Fortress nearby? No. I can't see one, unfortunately. It's all just crimson forest. Oh no, that's gonna be annoying to deal with. So many hoglins. Well, there's nothing I can do about that. So, I think the first thing we should do is find some turtles for a turtle helmet, because that's gonna be a massive help for- Ooh, there's a creeper there. So I would quite like to find turtles for a turtle helmet, because that's gonna be a huge help for flooding the Nether. Especially in the early game, I don't think I would be able to survive doing the initial flooding at least, without a turtle helmet. So let's craft a boat, that's gonna be pretty useful for this. And we'll try and find the ocean that I found in the last episode again. It should be just beyond the Nether portal that I found. So here is the ocean. I would quite like to pick up a lot of the kelp here as well, because that's what I'm going to use to create more water sources in the Nether. Because since I've updated, I'm not able to use the glow lichen trick anymore. Hopefully I won't need too many, because it's gonna grow on itself when I plant it in the Nether. Yes, give me your kelp. Give me all of the kelp. So I guess I should probably just explore the ocean until I find some turtles. Hopefully I might find something interesting on the way as well. Oh, I've just found a beehive. And I don't have access to any bees back at the Nether portal that I have set up next to. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put one block in the entrance in front of this beehive, and that will prevent the bees from ever being able to escape again. So let's just put that there. And I think they're wandering around aimlessly at the moment. I don't think there's any flowers next to the hive itself, so just pick up a few of those and we'll try and guide them back again. Come with me, bees. Thank you very much. All of you, just follow me. And pollinate yourselves just here, please. Go on, go in the hive. There we go. Right, so I'll be able to come back for that hive later, once I have silk touch. Oh, I have found some turtles. Two turtles is just enough for me. So, what I need now is shears, and luckily I brought those with me. And I just need to break some of the seagrass near here, and we'll breed these turtles together, and hopefully we'll get 5 eggs out of it. I think they can lay 4 eggs at a time, or up to 4 eggs at a time. It's random between 1 and 4, so I'm gonna need to breed these guys up a little bit. We're also gonna have to hang around here at nighttime too, which is not going to be fun, but it is what it is. And he's given us 4 turtle eggs, excellent. That's good. So given that I'm going to be here at nighttime, I should probably create like a nice little temporary hut, I guess, for the turtles. Oh, it's becoming nighttime, I need to get on with this immediately. I don't want to sleep the night away either, because that means I have to wait even longer. Come on. Come on, Whistler. Don't see me, skeleton, please. Just let me finish off this wall. I don't think he's seen me. That's good. And here we go. So I think this will probably do. I might add some slabs to the gap just there to prevent baby zombies from getting in. But this should be enough to keep me and the turtles safe for the nighttime. And they'll just hatch as they go. I'm going to keep breeding them up as well, just in case I want to come back here later for turtle eggs or something. Oh, those eggs just cracked. That's excellent. So those eggs will advance. Oh, those cracked again. Okay, those eggs right there have just advanced 2 stages in 1 night. I didn't know that was possible. Well, that's pretty cool. I might get those earlier than the others then. That's the hope anyway. Well, it's daytime now, so I think we'll leave the turtles for now. And we'll try and explore a little bit. Maybe there's something cool in this vast ocean here. Ah, so over here, I believe we have a snowy tiger. That's pretty cool. I haven't even found a snowy biome in my other hardcore worlds yet. So this is a first for the channel, I think. I have spied a shipwreck. It's time to loot this thing. Oh, there's a ruined village here as well, actually. I didn't even notice that. So hopefully in this shipwreck, we'll get some good loot. Where's the chest? There's the chest. Ooh, a decent amount of iron, that's good. Some lapis as well. And an emerald. Okay, well, those are good finds, I guess. I would quite like the treasure map chest, though. So, when shipwrecks generate inside of, like, islands like this, odds are they've actually generated the rest of the ship underneath the stone and the sand as well. So it's always worth digging them out. So what's in this chest? Quite a bit of paper. And 2 coal. Okay. I think I might try to keep the paper as well as the coal. I think they'll be useful. I need as many of those early game resources as possible at the moment. I need a get-rich-quick scheme in this series, I think. Because all the materials I want to use are late-game things. Now, unfortunately, I was not able to find another chest in here. I don't know if it just didn't generate. So, unfortunately, that means no treasure map. I guess I'll have to look elsewhere for that. It's becoming nighttime once again, though, so we should probably head back to the turtle hut over here. And we'll wait out the night with those guys again. Try and get those eggs to hatch, hopefully. So I'm not just spending my time doing nothing here. I'm trying to smelt up some stuff here as well. I'd also quite like some glass, because the first exhibit I would like to make for the aquarium is an axolotl tank. And I think we'll try and make that for the next episode. But for this one, I'd quite like to try and gather as many of the resources as possible for it. And that includes glass. Oh, the turtles just hatched. On the second night, I didn't know that was possible. Oh, they're so adorable. Look how small they are. They're so tiny. Wow, I think baby turtles... Oh, more just hatched. Wow. I think baby turtles are one of the cutest things in Minecraft. There is no contest. Just look at how tiny they are. Oh, and we've got some more eggs cracking as well. This is good though, because it means that I have a chance to get 8 scoots, which means I have more than enough for a turtle helmet, provided that these turtles grow up. I would quite like to give them a little bit more space though, so let's create a nice little pool here. We'll try to make it a darkroom pool as well, because I've looked at the spawning mechanics for axolotls and I've not managed to find any yet. But they should be able to spawn in complete darkness in water if there is a stone block less than 5 blocks beneath it. So if I make this a darkroom pool and lay the floor with stone blocks like this, I was smelting this up just then I should be able to spawn an axolotl after a while. Or at least that's the theory. I hope that works. I'd also probably need to leave the room for that to work as well. Oh! My turtles have grown! They've grown! Give me the scoots! Give me the scoots! I need the scoots! They're not letting me move. How many have I got? I think they've all just grown up right in front of me. I've got 4. I need 5. Give me a 5th one, please. There's one! Excellent. Okay, we've got ourselves a turtle helmet now. Excellent. That's going to make flooding the Nether so much easier. Oh, and I forgot. They make me lose my eyebrows. Rest in peace to the eyebrows. May they thrive in the afterlife. So I've just seen dead fish outside of this this turtle hut. So I believe that there should be an axolotl somewhat nearby here, actually. I can't see one right now, but there must have been one nearby, and it must have killed the fish here, I think. Unless there's something else that kills fish that I don't know about. Do dolphins kill fish? I don't know enough about dolphins. Maybe there was an axolotl, maybe there wasn't. But I am going to force them to spawn. So, all I need to do is pillar up high above the dark room pool that I have constructed, and hopefully they will spawn below, because the aquatic mobs will have nowhere else to spawn other than that dark room pool because of the 128 block spawn radius. And I might want to come back up here, so we'll leave a water source at the top here as well. I'm a little bit worried of phantoms. I feel like they might try and surprise me at some point. I think I might actually want the water source up here to be a single pillar rather than spraying out the sides, though. So let's create a nice little circle there. Oh, wait, no phantoms. I hear them. Scratch that. We're leaving that there, and we're jumping off. I'm not letting them throw me off in the wrong direction, and I don't have a bow to tackle them properly. That is not a fight I want to take on this early in the series. But let's see if we manage to get some spawns in here. I hear some zombies. I think they're nearby. Oh, I've gotten a glow squid. And we've got axolotls. Excellent. So let's just put some torches here. We've got one glow squid. And I think four axolotls. Let's pick this one up. This is the first axolotl. We'll try and pick up these pink ones as well. There we go. Excellent. This farm has turned out so well. It wasn't even supposed to be like a proper farm. Although I guess it probably could serve as one. And these turtles seem very active at the moment for some reason. I'm not sure what that is about. But I would quite like to pick up the other axolotls in here as well. So let's craft two new buckets. And we'll pick up these two pink axolotls as well. There we go. Excellent. So now we have some axolotls that we can use in the axolotl exhibit in the next episode. Brilliant. And I can breed them together as well. So the good thing about this pool being able to spawn axolotls and glow squids is that, in my mind, it makes it a lot easier to transport the 1.17 mobs towards the Nether Aquarium. I know exactly what I need to do now in order to get them there. Now, this axolotl here, I believe, was the first axolotl I picked up, so I will claim them as my personal pet. I will probably keep them in my inventory at all times. Might be fun to bring them out every now and then. And then these other axolotls, I'll place them in a separate chest for now, but I'll bring them back home with me. This first axolotl, though, I think I will call them Alice. Alice the Axolotl. I hope you like that name, everyone. So that's some of our goals achieved already in this episode. I have axolotls. I have a turtle helmet. Progress is progress. And that means that... Ooh, I just picked up something. Don't know what that was. Help. Okay, that's interesting. So, that means that I can flood the Nether with less issues today. And I've already worked on things I need for the future. Now, the axolotl exhibit that I want to build is going to end up using a lot of glass. So, I don't really have access to a proper desert in this world yet. I don't know where one is, because I have no idea what the seed is. It's a random seed, and I don't want to look at that right now. So, I guess we're going to have to scavenge some sand from the sides of this river, and we'll have to smelt that up, try and get as much as possible. So, I broke a couple of shovels just then, but I think we've got enough sand for the exhibit that I would like to use. I'll just start that process now though, so I don't have to wait for that in the future. I might even place two more furnaces here, I think they'll be useful. And the other block that I would like to use in the axolotl exhibit is blue terracotta. And I don't have access to a mesa, or badlands as I think they're now called. So instead I'm going to have to mine up a bunch of clay, and we'll have to smelt that as well. Which might be a little bit painful, but it's the only thing I can do. the design I've gone for, it uses so many late game resources that I just don't have access to right now. So, that is four stacks of clay blocks. I think that will probably be enough for now. I don't need too much, I don't think. I hope I'm right about that anyway. So I've actually already designed the axolotl exhibit in a creative test world, and it uses a ton of expensive resources like smooth quartz. And I just have zero access to that. It's going to take ages to get that. Might have to substitute that for another block at first. And the other thing I would like to use is sea lanterns and end rods, and I have zero of those, and I'm not going to get access to those for ages. Hopefully it's not too much of a grind. Now, I am having a bit of a fuel issue at the moment, because I haven't really gone mining, like, properly yet. So I think for now, we're going to grab some logs, and we're going to turn them into charcoal, and I think that will work well for our fuel source for now. So let's just put the coal in there, get them smelted up. So this should produce one charcoal, and it should be just as effective as normal coal. So these furnaces are just going to smelt away, and we should get a lot of terracotta and a lot of glass out of them. And of course, blue terracotta means blue dye, so there's a bunch of blue flowers over here. We'll try and gather up as many of these as possible, just so that I have enough. And the next resource I would like to use is deep slate. So that's a brand new 1.17 block. They currently generate in small blobs close to Y0. In 1.18, they will cover up 99% of the overworld below Y0, but that's not a thing yet. We don't have those world heights yet. So for now, they are just in the small blobs, so they're quite difficult to find. So I suggest we go on a mining session. I will start from here in the 21 WO3A chunks, and we'll just mine in a very straight line to the new chunks, and hopefully we'll get some diamonds along the way too. So I think we're just going to make a start to that branch mine down here. Let's see how it goes. And these are new items, actually. Raw iron. So mining iron has actually been completely reworked. It drops raw iron rather than the iron ore blocks, and you'd have to smelt those instead. And I think that's pretty cool, because it also means that iron is now fortunable. That's a very cool feature. I don't have fortune at the moment though, so we'll have to wait for that. Oh, I spy another cave. I wonder where this one goes. I think we should scout it out. So I think I should have enough torches for this. I'm a little bit wary of everything at the moment. I feel so fragile at the start of hardcore series. Oh, we've got tuff. Interesting. I think they generate in small blobs in 1.17, but because I think we're in snapshot chunks at the moment. Let's just get these skeletons to kill each other. Thank you for the bone. So because we're in snapshot chunks at the moment, this should actually be an amethyst geode. There we go. So the blocks haven't been changed to smooth basalt because I generated this part of the world in the snapshot. So that's really interesting. I found my first amethyst geode already. That's excellent. I'd quite like to explore this thing. So there's actually a hole here that I didn't notice. So you can actually see inside that the crystals give off their own little light source. It's not enough to stop mobs from spawning, as you can see from that zombie, but it's enough to create a nice little ambient effect that I would quite like to use in the Netherquarium. So it's good that I've got this geode here, because I can use that in the future. And I'll also mine these shards as well, because one thing I can use them for is crafting a spyglass. And I quite liked using a spyglass in the armorless world, so that's one thing I will definitely use. And I'll definitely try to craft one as soon as possible as well. But yeah, here we go. Our first geode. It's not too dangerous in here. It's pretty easy to light up. But you can just hear it very faintly. I don't know if you can hear that. But it makes a nice sound walking on it. I really do like the amethyst blocks. A nice little chiming noise. I don't really have a use for the entire geode just yet though, so we'll come back for that in the future. It's just good to know that it's there. So I believe the recipe is 2 iron and 1 shard, 1 amethyst shard, and there we go. We have our spyglass. Excellent. So, I tried to zoom in F5 mode just then, but oh, I've been very clumsy about this. Oh, actually, I should probably block off this nether portal. I'm a little bit worried about creepers wandering through. It would be good to have them not be able to do that. In fact, let's change these to fence gates, and that way I don't have to break blocks in order to get in and out. So the awesome thing about the spyglass is that it serves as a vanilla zoom feature. Not only that, but it can also double up on the Optifine zoom as well. So I can zoom in really hard on that flower over there. That's pretty cool. And I can even go one step further. So I can zoom in down this staircase and I can change the FOV to make it zoom even further, like so. And then this is Optifine zoom on top of that. It's like adjusting the scope of a sniper rifle. This is awesome. Spyglasses are so much cooler than I thought they'd be. I already thought that they were good, but they're much better than I first thought. Oh! We have diamonds! Oh, excellent! That's a good sight to see. And it's got a new ore texture as well. It's interesting to see it like that. So, I think we should see how many we've got here. I don't want to mine them just yet. I'm saving mining diamonds for when I get Fortune 3. I want to make the most out of that. So, I believe we have 5 diamond ores. No, we've got 6 diamond ores here. Excellent. So, I'll be able to come back and mine these in the future. And of course, how could I not do this? I have to validate these diamonds. Are they real diamonds? I think they are real. You can tell from the texture. They are indeed shiny blue rocks. Oh, I think I've successfully inspected these diamond ores. What do you think? Oh, how far can I zoom in on these things? Oh, that is very far. Okay, this is too far actually. Now I'm curious because I can see down this hallway here. So can I see these diamond ores from the other end if I zoom in really far? So let's see how this looks. Can I see the diamond ores from here? How powerful is the zoom? I don't think I can just here. Hang on, let's try and get a better angle. Can I see the diamond ores? Actually, I think I can just see a very faint vertical line that is the diamond ores over there. So that's pretty cool. The fact that I can only just barely see that from this far away. Oh, we have more diamonds. Oh, that's excellent. Oh, they're real too. This has been a very good mining session so far. So, I believe we have 4 diamond ores here at the moment, which is good enough for me. We'll save these for when I have Fortune 3 as well. Ooh, I think we've got a mineshaft just there. So, the interesting thing about mineshafts in 1.17 is that they are currently the only way to obtain glowberries. So, there's a chest just there as well. So, that's lucky. So, I'd quite like to see if we can try our luck with this minecart chest and see if we can't get any glowberries out of it. Oh, it does have glowberries! 3 glowberries! I don't know how useful they're going to be in this series, given that I'm making an aquarium that they can't exist in. But they are an excellent natural light source for caves now. I'd love to have these in my other hardcore world. It's definitely something I'm going to have to go scouting for. I think I can also make a bow out of the string that drops from these cobwebs, so I think we should do that real quick. I don't have a bow yet. So the recipe has appeared in the book just there. Let's just grab the bow. And there we go. We don't have any arrows at the moment, so we can't really use it. But I'm so glad that we finally have something that I can use as a ranged weapon. I rely on bows so much in Minecraft, but at the moment, it's still a bit useless, so I don't have any arrows. Oh, we have more diamonds! Excellent, and I think this is a ravine here. Okay, so that's a bit dangerous, but the fact that I have more diamonds here is an excellent situation to find oneself in. So, I believe we've actually got another 6 diamond ores here. That's brilliant! So, the fact that I've successfully found glowberries in that minecart chest should mean that I am in 1.17 chunks right now. Which means I should be coming across deep slate blobs, but I've not seen any yet. I don't know how rare they are, but given that deep slate is the resource that I wanted to use in my axolotl exhibit, I'm a little bit sad that I haven't found them yet. I hope it doesn't take too long. Oh! I finally found it! A deep slate blob. This took a lot longer than I thought it would. So this is the new type of stone that generates in the overworld. It's going to become a lot more abundant in 1.18 when it generates in the entirety of below Y0. But for now, we've got these blobs, and I would like to obtain these so that I can use them in my Netherquarium. I think they'd make a nice floor texture. Oh, we've also got on our first example of a deep slate ore. So 1.17 has introduced deep slate ore variants. That's very cool. I think I'll leave those for now. I don't know if I want to try and salt touch them later, because I quite like how they look. Oh! I wasn't expecting diamonds there. That's right next to the hallway. I'm surprised that I wasn't able to see that just there. Wow. Excellent. I wonder how many we've got. So I believe we have 5 diamond ores here, and if I just inspect them real close, you can see that they are definitely blue shiny rocks. So I guess our next plan of action is getting ourselves a Fortune 3 pickaxe, and luckily enough, I know exactly where a village is, so we can try and rotate the trades around with the librarian and see how that goes. I should be able to force Fortune 3 out of them. The first thing I need though is emeralds, and I have no emeralds other than the one I found in a chest earlier. So, what I'm going to do first is actually turn this villager into a fletcher. So let's destroy this stone cutter here. I've crafted a fletching table for him to use, and I should be able to trade sticks with him. Although, not in this case. How about now, sir? Sticks? Sticks! Excellent. You are my guy. So let's craft a bunch of those real quick and try and get as many emeralds as possible from him. Now, I was able to get quite a few emeralds out of that villager, so I've moved straight on to trying to get Fortune 3 out of this one. Hopefully it doesn't take too long for me to cycle his trades and force it out of him. It'll happen eventually, but the fact that it's all RNG related, it's not good. Oh! We have it! The 42 emeralds! Excellent! I've gotten my anvil here. Let's stick that straight on the diamond pickaxe. I will have my fortune pickaxe. Excellent. I'll be able to get so rich from mining ores now. That's brilliant. And I think the next book that I would like to get is mending, because that always works well with fortune. I've just heard a wandering trader. Where is he? Where is he? There is his llamas. Where is he, though? There he is. What have you got for me? These trades are all sort of bad looking. Although, are those melon seeds? Excellent. Okay. Thank you very much. I don't have melons at the moment. So I'll be able to grow those, but thank you for your services. Please die. Thank you very much. Oh my goodness, llamas take so long to kill. How much health did I have? I didn't realize I had so much. That's a lot of strikes. Oh, there we go. We finally have our mending villager. The 26 emeralds, that's kind of expensive for mending, but it is what it is. I have it now, and it's going straight on this diamond pickaxe. That's excellent. Oh, hello, creeper. That wasn't what I wanted to see. There's plenty of mobs around me at the moment, because I was cycling that villager's trades all the way through the night. Okay, I don't know where he went just then. I don't know how dangerous leaving this place is going to be either. So, when in doubt, escape out the back. Let's run. Run for it. I'm not hearing any footsteps. I think I've gotten away with it. Excellent. So, I believe that it is time that we fortune our diamonds. I'm going to try and mine all of the diamonds, and let's see how many we get. I think, generally, you can expect to double your diamonds if you have Fortune 3. So, hopefully you get as many as that. And that diamond ore only gave me one. Okay. That is not a good start. So, let's mine these diamonds. Hopefully they give me a little bit more. Now I have 8. There was only 6 ores there, so only one gave me more than one. Oh dear. Please give me multiple diamonds! Right, okay, that was a lot more luckier. Here's the next diamonds. Let's see how many we get from here. They're all looking like they're only giving me single diamonds at the moment. That's unfortunate. Okay. Six diamonds out of 6 diamond ores. That's not good luck. Wait, hang on. Did I just use the wrong pickaxe? Oh my goodness. Oh, that's my bad. Get that iron pickaxe out of my hotbar right now. Jeez. And here's the final 5 diamond ores. Let's see how many we got. We now have 32 diamonds. Okay. I'm pretty happy with that. I think that's enough for me to go ahead and construct the rest of my gear, like the armor and the diamond sword and the axe and the shovel and all that sort of good stuff. So let's craft ourselves a diamond chest plate, diamond leggings, and the diamond boots. And there we go, we now have a set of diamond armor to go with our turtle helmet. That's awesome. In fact, we're going to make the diamond helmet as well, because that's what we're going to be using in the overworld, I believe. The turtle shell is for the nether. Has anyone ever said that before? Am I the first one to utter that sentence? I might well be, you know. And of course, that means we can craft some new tools. So we'll get ourselves a diamond shovel, a diamond sword. I won't be able to enchant those just yet, but I'll love it when I'm able to. The diamond axe as well. And I would love to craft a new pickaxe here, because I would be able to turn that into a silk touch pickaxe at some point. But I'm one diamond short, unfortunately. So I wonder if I should just keep mining. Yeah, let's keep mining. Oh, seriously? I've already found the diamonds. They were very close by. I've barely moved. So I believe we've got 5 incredibly real looking diamond ores here. I suggest we mine them and see how many we get. Hopefully we get a lot luckier this time. Oh, there's 6 diamond ores. Okay. 13 diamonds. That's more like it. You should expect to double your diamonds, and I've definitely done that with at least this vein. So, a new diamond pickaxe is what I wanted, and I think, just because I can, the diamond hoe. And there we go, fully tooled up. So I was able to get a bone from those 2 skeletons fighting earlier, so I was wondering if we should try and tame this dog, and he's done in the first go. Oh, I didn't think I'd get that. Kill this chicken, dog. Kill it. Ah, oh, such a wonderful companion. Kill the sheep. Get the sheep. Yes, good doggo. Thank you very much, doggo. Who's a good doggo? You are. Have some chicken. Good dog. So, doggo, I would like you to meet Alice the axolotl. Now, I've just got to say to you, doggo, I don't know what your name is yet, doggo, but you are not allowed to eat Alice the axolotl. That is right off the table, okay? You understand that, Mr. Dog? Yes? I hope you do. There'll be hell to pay if you kill Alice. Oh, let's just get these 2 side by side, though. Alice doesn't really want to look in the same direction as us at the moment, so this screenshot opportunity isn't working as well as it should. But there we go. 2 pets in the world. Let's just pick Alice up again, though. I know a lot of you are probably getting nervous from me having her out at the moment just there. Oh, hang on. There's a cat just there. Okay, this is an opportunity for a 3rd pet. That cat must have wandered over from the village nearby. So, let's get ourselves some salmon.
Die, salmon. Your sacrifice will be worth it.
Here, kitty, 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 kitty. Here, kitty, 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 kitty. Come on, jelly cat. Come on. Have some fish. Ah, there we go. We have our very first cat. Excellent. I think I would like to park this cat right next to the mine entrance and the nether portal, because that's where I think I'm most vulnerable from creepers, because I can't really see out of the mine here. But yeah, we now have 2 new pets that need names. So leave your suggestions down in the comments below, and I'll pick some of my favourites for the cat and for the dog. I think it's time that we move on to trying to flood the nether, though. It's time that we begin that process, because I believe that I have the minimum required gear for that at the moment. There might actually be a creeper on the other side of this. I don't know if any managed to wander through before I put up these fence gates, but if they did, then I've got to be prepared. So diamond helmet is on. Let's see how this goes. Oh, nothing. Nothing. Okay, that's good. Okay, I was worried there would be a creeper or something on the other side. Let's put that turtle helmet back on. So here we are, back at the mother source. So what I would like to do is I would like to branch out in each direction, north, south, east, and west from this water source, and also diagonally as well. And that way it should enable me to use the water source forming mechanics in order to try and flood the nether below. And I'll do that by digging holes through the entire nether. So with these straight lines, I can have a block gap because water sources can form within those gaps. And I think we'll go 10 blocks in each direction as well. Trying to go at least 10 blocks in an episode, I think will result in some significant growth over time, provided I can actually pull it off. And of course, for the diagonal lines, there's going to need to be a lot more holes. And a tunnel feels a lot longer too. So, for now, I would like to fill these holes with wood, and then we'll release the source from the middle of the nether here. And then that will allow the water to flow over these holes a little bit, and then we'll remove the wood and add kelp. Now, I do still need to turn this central column into source blocks, so let's just do that with the kelp here. There we go. And that has allowed the water to spread out over these wood blocks. And now that it's spread out, I can remove the wood and place kelp where they are. And that should allow the roof to flood with water. So, let's just get that started. Wood removal, kelp replacement. And then the kelp, as it grows, will be able to grow into the flowing water, and that will allow it to spread even further. Well, this is taking a very long time. I think in the future I need some sort of system that generates me bone meal, because at the moment I can't place kelp on top of other kelp in these shallow flowing water areas, so that's something I've got to be aware of. Hopefully this doesn't take too long though. Well, it's time for me to begin flooding the nether below. So to do this, we're going to dig holes throughout the entire nether where I've already placed the kelp up above, and then that will allow water sources to form at the bottom, provided I add the kelp at the bottom as well. And I should be able to use the doors that I've got on my hotbar in order to breathe as well, because it's all just flowing water currently, although doors can't be waterlogged in Java yet. But yeah, we just need to dig down very carefully. I don't want to fall down to my death. Okay, we've already come across our first pit of death that I have to be wary of. There's a lot of nether trees here, unfortunately. I wonder how much they will interrupt the sources from forming. I might have to remove them all, unfortunately. Oh, okay, there's another pit of death for me to fall into. Good to know. Let's just allow myself to breathe before I go down there. There is, in fact, plenty of space in this nether, though. It's not too cramped, so I should be able to get some decent space for the Netherquarium, at least. For the Subnautica build that I have planned. So here we go, we are at Y32 at the moment, because I believe that this is where the lava ocean begins to generate. Every air block beneath here does not exist. It's all just lava. So there's no point in trying to take the water any lower than Y32. So I believe that that's going to be a good stopping point for me. And then at the bottom here, we're just going to place a piece of kelp. And we'll let that grow over time, and at some point that should reach the top of the nether. I spy a warped forest over there. Okay, that's good to know. It's the first hint of any other biome at the moment. But I think I'm just going to get on with trying to get this process done as fast as possible. Let's get some more of these streams done. So I've done some more of the streams here, as you can see, and I've just realized I'm going to have a bit of an issue with lava casting in this world. I'm already forming cobble just down there, and while that's great news that I can create a cobble generator in the nether if I wanted, it also means that I have to remove all of the falling lava sources at the moment, because otherwise they're just going to form massive lava casts that I have to remove. Well, that's a bit unfortunate. The game just crashed on me, and I don't know if it's... Oh, some weird effects just there with the rain. I don't know if it's an issue with 1.17 that caused that crash just then, or if it's because I'm doing something I'm not supposed to. Hopefully, it's not too much of an issue with me adding water to the nether. I don't see why it would be an issue towards the game itself. I mean, it's just water, isn't it? Oh, we have our first lava pocket. That's not good. We've also just created obsidian in the nether. How many of you have done that before? Okay, so I need to mine this without potentially falling through into lava below if it happens to be there. So I think I need to be in the water as well at the same time. And this is taking a very long time. Oh my goodness. That took a solid minute of mining within the water there. I need efficiency 5 and I need a better method for dealing with lava sources, because that was painful. Oh wow. If I position myself just right on this falling water, then I think I get a good example of what the nether might look like filled with water. It's quite eerie. I quite like that view. I hope the final product resembles that in some way. Oh, we've got another lava pocket. That's not good. Okay, let's work out a way of dealing with this more efficiently. So I think if I just dig a hole in the side and stand in there and mine the obsidian from here, that should allow me to get through the obsidian a lot faster. Of course, though, I do still need to get efficiency 5. It does still take a while. But I'm through. So I have created falling water sources going north, south, west, and east. We are going 10 blocks in each direction. I like that there's a lot of space for me to build my aquarium in this nether. I think that's a definite plus of this project. But I think one of the interesting things is that the water spreads really quite far without me even realizing. Like, it's already all the way down there, and the water's behind me. It's going far. But hopefully, this whole place will eventually be flooded with water, and I'll be able to do some really awesome builds in here. I wonder if I'll be able to keep the nether particles within the flood. Is that a thing? Can you see nether particles from within water? Now, unfortunately, making those holes did take a very long time to do, though, so I'm going to need to work out a better and faster way of doing this. Maybe that's just efficiency 5 and a netherite pickaxe. I think that will probably be a massive help in this regard, as well as aqua affinity and respiration. But for now, I don't know how much of this nether I'm going to be able to flood in each episode. It's definitely something I'm going to have to try and work a more efficient way to do. I'm going to have to make that the end of the episode, though. So, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to leave a like down below. And if you want to see how this project ends up turning out, be sure to subscribe. And I guess I'll see you in the next one. But on that note, bye! Thanks for watching.